57 हो गए सर पिछले 10 साल में, तो अब तैयारी करने के लिए 157 का करना पड़ रहा है सर अभी।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 43 बालाशोरी
सर। क्वेश्चन नंबर 43
has been placed on the table of the house.
Mananiya sadasya
sir, first I congratulate Sri Ramohan Naidu garu for becoming a civil aviation minister. He is the youngest minister in the cabinet and I wish him all the success. Sir, this airport, Vijayawada airport, comes under my parliamentary constituency. As the chairman of airport advisory committee, I have visited and reviewed the ongoing development works at the airport many occasions. These works were started 2019 and they were supposed to be completed by 2022. But till today, there is no major usable progress. Sir, what is the reason behind the delay? And since Honorable Minister is from my state, he understands the importance of this airport. It is our capital city's airport, that is Amaravati, which is the new capital of AP.
Okay, Manimuthu.
Therefore,
supplementary,
this airport is important for us. Sir, my question is, what is the new deadline for completion of this project? And how does this minister make sure that this time all the proposed works will be completed before the set deadlines?
Speaker sir, I totally agree with what the Honorable Member of Parliament has raised here, that this was a work which was started in June 2020, sir, and the overall estimated cost of the project was 611 crores. And there has been subsequent delay which was observed because of the COVID that has happened, and also because like the member has mentioned, I also come from the state, sir. It is the capital airport that we have. But for the last few years, there have been other external factors also in the state which has hampered the progress of this, especially due to the availability of sand and other materials in the state, sir. But right now, we are ensuring that it is going to be completed on time. I've taken it up as a top priority, and the new deadline that we have fixed is June 2025, sir, for this project.
Supplementary puchna hai?
Yes, sir.
Ji. Short mein.
Sir, at the outset, let me also thank Honorable Minister as soon as he took the charge. He introduced two flights, Vijayawada to Mumbai. Earlier, there was a no flight to Mumbai. This was a long pending demand. Sir.
And to Delhi. Vijayawada, Delhi.
Sir, and we are requesting, we need a flight from Vijayawada to Calcutta, Vijayawada to Varanasi, and additional flight to Delhi to Visakhapatnam and Tirupati also. And there is a demand for the flights to Sri Lanka, Thailand and Singapore also.
Okay.
So I would like to know from the minister whether these sir. Sectors are also in the consideration of the minister.
Sir, this will open up
a new... Mananiya Mantri Ji.
Sir.
ये बहुत अच्छा संकेत है इस देश के लिए कि सभी देश की जनता का और जनता के माध्यम से माननीय सदस्यों की आकांक्षा जगने लगी है कि मेरे यहाँ भी एयरपोर्ट बन जाएगा. ये अच्छे संकेत है देश के लिए.
सर, वेरी मच सर. And like I've just mentioned, the infrastructure around airports has increased so much in the last 10 years. A huge push has been given for civil aviation ministry. And right now, the way members are raising up their demands and asking for new airports or connectivity, it was almost, if you go back 10 years or 20 years back, it used to be the demand with railway, sir. Tab railway se puchte the ki train chahiye ya fir stop chahiye. Ab wo halat airways mein aa gaya hai, sir. So airways is the new railways of the country, and I'm very proud about it. And especially regarding the connectivity, नहीं नहीं उसी के बारे में बोल रहा हूँ.
आप उनका जवाब मत दो.
दादा उसी के बारे में बोल रहा हूँ सर. बट द ऑनरेबल मेंबर हैज मेंशन अबाउट द कनेक्टिविटी, बट लेट मी मेक इट क्लियर फ्रॉम द मिनिस्ट्री सर, वी डोंट हैव एनी डायरेक्ट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन विच वी वेयर वी इंटरफेयर विद द कनेक्टिविटी ऑफ द एयरलाइंस. इट इज एंटायरली अ डिमांड ड्रिवन प्रोसेस, मार्केट ड्रिवन प्रोसेस, एंड द एयरलाइंस डिसाइड विच कनेक्टिविटी. वी ऑफर द इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर. अगर एयरलाइंस बोलता है कि यहाँ से ये मैं वहाँ तक चलाना चाहता हूँ, तो वी इंश्योर दैट देर इज एयरपोर्ट कनेक्टिविटी ऑन बोथ द प्लेसेस. बट वॉट वी डू सर, बिकॉज देर हैज बीन अ बिग डिमांड फ्रॉम ऑल द मेंबर्स की हमें यहाँ से ये कनेक्टिविटी चाहिए, वी आर जस्ट फॉरवर्डिंग द रिक्वेस्ट टू द एयरलाइंस एंड आस्किंग देम टू फेवरेबली कंसिडर अकॉर्डिंग टू द डिमांड ऑफ दैट एयरपोर्ट सर.
कल्याण बनर्जी जी, सुदीप बंदोपाध्याय जी. कल्याण जी आपका सुदीप दादा ने छीन लिया।
सुदीप दादा, ही इज माय लीडर, ही इज माय लीडर, ऑफ कोर्स ही इज माय लीडर,
सर
ही इज माय लीडर।
आई एम हैप्पी टू सी दिस यंग मिनिस्टर हुज फादर वाज माय वन ऑफ माय बेस्ट फ्रेंड्स इन पीएलटी।
माननीय मंत्री जी सक्रिय हैं बहुत ज्यादा।
हिज फादर यरन्ना नायडू वाज माय वेरी डियर फ्रेंड बालू वाज देयर, दैट वाज लॉन्ग रेजिम बैक 12th and 13th Lok Sabha. He knows it well. So my question is, Calcutta is always, or Bengal is always, neglected from all corners. Why second international airport in Calcutta is not taking shape? Proposal has been taken up. Monetary allotment has been done. Space has been proposed by the state government. But why not government is initiating the proposal? One reply is being given by the government that the distance of the second airport from Calcutta has some long distance. But if the government agrees, if the people of Bengal agree, if land is available, why not this second airport international is being initiated immediately, which is the desire and expectation of the people of Calcutta and Bengal for a long time? Will the minister reply in a positive form?
Thank you, sir. And I'd like to thank the honorable senior member also, who has given his blessings. And especially regarding Calcutta, sir, the need is there. And definitely, if the land is available and the state also supports for the construction and other the connectivity between the two airports, the two locations, that is there. And definitely we are going to take it up positively, sir. And I would request him that we'll definitely meet up after the session also. We can have a special meeting regarding the Kolkata airport, sir, and the development of the new terminal.
Maanye sadasyagano, sabki bahut maang hai is vishay pe, bahut sare maanye sadasyon ke supplementary question aaye. Is baar agar samay bacha to is baar, nahi to agli baar कॉल अटेंशन में लेकर इस पर सभी माननीय सदस्यों को बोलने का समय देंगे, ताकि डिटेल चर्चा हो जाए जो कुछ भी परिवर्तन हुए। शॉर्ट में पप्पू यादव जी, शॉर्ट में पूछना, एक लाइन में।
मैं माननीय मंत्री महोदय से आपके माध्यम से पूछना चाहूँगा कि गृह मंत्री अमित शाह जी भी और प्रधानमंत्री जी ने भी कई बार पूर्णिया एयरपोर्ट, भागलपुर एयरपोर्ट के का जिक्र कर चुके हैं कि वो खुल गया, हो गया। अभी तक पूर्णिया लैंड जो बिहार सरकार के द्वारा अधिग्रहण होना था, जिसमें 15 एकड़ लैंड अभी तक अधिग्रहण नहीं है। मैं आपसे मिल करके भी पूर्णिया एयरपोर्ट के निर्माण कार्य की शुरुआत करने का मैंने आग्रह किया है।
माननीय मंत्री जी,
क्या इस साल में पूर्णिया एयरपोर्ट का आप शिलान्यास करके दो साल के अंदर क्या वहाँ विमान चालू करने का कोई आपका निर्णय है, ये मैं आपसे पूछ रहा
हूँ। जी बैठ जाइए, नहीं तो लोग कहेंगे बिहार को बहुत ज्यादा दे रहे हैं।
सर, माननीय सांसद जी हमसे मिल चुके हैं सर इसी इसके, और हमारे अधिकारियों से भी उन्होंने जानकारी ली है, और जो भी थोड़ा जमीन का जो इशू था वो भी अभी सेटल होने वाला है सर। तो तुरंत
दीपेंद्र हुड्डा जी
उसके उसमें प्रारंभ करेंगे।
दीपेंद्र हुड्डा, संबित पात्रा जी, शॉर्ट में।
धन्यवाद, आपने ये मौका दिया है। आपके माध्यम से मैं माननीय मंत्री जी से पूछना चाहता हूँ पूरी इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट के विषय में। 2021 में इस एयरपोर्ट के विषय में देर वॉज अ नीड विच अरोज फॉर द इंटरनेशनल एयरपोर्ट इन पूरी, एंड इन द ईयर 2023 द ग्रांट फॉर द साइट क्लियरेंस वॉज फॉरवर्डेड बाई द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ सिविल एविएशन। I just want to know what is the progress in this field, because the airport is to be built in Brahmagiri Tehsil, very close to the Jagannath Temple, and because of the relevance of Jagannath Temple and Puri being a tourist destination, this airport is of prime importance. So I would like to know through the Honorable Speaker as to how we have progressed in this field. Thank you.
Sir, Puri.
Puri ka airport. I will support it.
Yes, yes.
Jaldi kijiye.
ओके
सर, पूरी 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 जो भगवान जगन्नाथ जी का क्षेत्र वाला एयरपोर्ट है, उसके उसके संबंध में सर, ये जो एयरपोर्ट है ग्रीनफील्ड एयरपोर्ट है सर, और ग्रीनफील्ड एयरपोर्ट जब बनता है सबसे पहले स्टेट हमें लिखता है कि यहाँ ये ज़मीन हम तैयार कर रहे हैं कि यहाँ पे एक नया एयरपोर्ट बने, और उसी तरह जब हमें प्रपोजल मिला मिनिस्ट्री को कि राज्य वहां पे एक एयरपोर्ट बनाना चाहता है, तो हमने उसका इनसाइट क्लियरेंस हमने दे दिया है सर। और जनरल प्रोसीजर ये रहता है आफ्टर इनसाइट आफ्टर साइट क्लियरेंस इन प्रिंसिपल अप्रूवल के लिए फिर से वो राज्य DPR बनाकर और उसका वो जो भी लैंड का हो, पावर का हो, वाटर का, वो सब तैयार कर वो फिर वापस हमें इन प्रिंसिपल अप्रूवल के लिए लिखता है सर। पर अभी तक हमें इन प्रिंसिपल अप्रूवल के लिए स्टेट से कोई कुछ वो आया नहीं सर। बट द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, बिकॉज इट इज़ अ ग्रीन फील्ड एयरपोर्ट बींग मेड ऑन PPP मोड, द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी रिलाइज विद द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द एयरपोर्ट। हम साइट क्लियरेंस देते हैं सर, वो दे दिया है, और अगर राज्य हमें लिखता है कि इन प्रिंसिपल अप्रूवल चाहिए तो हम जरूर उसके ऊपर कार्रवाई करके वो देंगे सर। पर अभी तक आया नहीं सर अप्रूवल।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 44, श्री शफी परिमल। हाँ बोलो आप, तो चालू जाएगा माइक, आप चिंता मत करो, आप बोलो क्वेश्चन नंबर, बोलो आप।
क्वेश्चन नंबर 44
सर, ऑन द टेबल ऑफ द हाउस।
माननीय सदस्य
सर, सर यू आर एन यंग मिनिस्टर, आई नो your answers will not be templates or copy paste. Sir, I know you will be having an intent to do something for our NRI communities. Sir, they are treated like people deported from the country by the airlines. At times the airline prices will be 5,000 or 6,000 for the same distance during the vacation, during the season. When they come to meet their family, they are being charged 50,000, 60,000, sir, even to 85,000 for economic class. Sir, how can a four-member family afford this? How can they come back? Sir, people at the time of their parents' death, they can't even come for their funeral, sir. It's a sad state of condition for our NRI party, sir. Something must happen. We must involve in, sir. They are not orphans. We have a government to question the airline companies treating them very bad. So I kindly request you involve in this to take some actions regarding this.
The honourable member has raised a very important question, sir, and of course I sympathize with the issues that he has flagged. And regarding the rules that we have within the ministry, sir, this is a market-driven approach that the airlines use for deciding the airfares. In fact, after I took charge as the Minister for Civil Aviation, my immediate commitment to the people of this country was I want to make the air prices affordable. I didn't know what was going through it. I was not aware of the rules. But I gave a commitment to the people that we are going to make it affordable, sir. And from my ministry, I am ensuring that whatever process can be involved in trying to ensure that happens, sir, we are trying to do. Now, right now, the rules are totally against doing that, sir. We don't have anything that at one point of time when the DGCA wanted to do something, also the courts also got involved, sir. It is a very, very tricky process. And even when deciding the air prices, there are a lot of factors, lot of parameters that come into play. And especially one situation that the whole country needs to be aware of, there are 800 odd planes in the country. And because of engine issues, sir, almost 120 planes are grounded right now. They are not able to fly because of the lack of aircraft that we have in our fleet. There is a lot of additional burden on the existing aircrafts also, which is also driving up the prices, sir. And right now, and the happy thing that the country should know is that we have 1,200 aircrafts on order, which is the highest in the world, sir. The country with the highest aircraft orders is India, and we are ensuring that they come on time, they be delivered on time, when we are ensuring from the ministry whatever best we can do in this. And additionally, sir, if there are already, like I said, civil aviation requirements, already rules in place which protects the passenger, if the airlines is trying to manipulate any situation, if they are not trying to give them prior information, if they are not trying to give them a refund, there are rules already in place. If the honorable member has any specific case that has happened, we are very much willing to support the case and fight on behalf of the passenger and ensure that his right is protected, sir. Customer is always the king. That is our priority in the ministry, sir. Thank you.
Sayoni Ghosh.
Sir, this extreme exploitation has become a new normal for them. Sir, 1,10,000 crore is the remittance from NRI people a state like us receive. Sir, what we give them back? Sir, why can't we constitute a high-level committee to check into this, to hear out our people, to know the social and economic consequences, to enact a new law, to stop this exploitation? Why can't we formulate a high-level committee, sir?
It is a suggestion being given by the honourable member, sir. We'll definitely look into it.
Sayoni Ghosh.
Thank you, Honourable Speaker, sir, and congratulations to our minister, sir. Sir, there has been a rampant increase of elderly passengers and senior citizens travelling by airline due to various causes like physical convenience and saving time. So is there any senior citizen discount or concession available right now? If so, then details thereof. And if not, then will the minister take into consideration any sort of concession or discount for senior citizens or measures for ease of commutation and easier access?
I would like to comment on behalf of the ministry, sir. Sir, definitely whatever best we can do for the differently abled community or the senior citizens of this country, we are going to do, sir. And I don't specifically have what is being done on that side, but I'll pass on the information to the honorable member, sir.
Sri Dayanidhi Maran.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, honorable speaker, sir. Sir, we have a young dynamic minister.
हम तो आपको मौका देते हैं, लेकिन आप हम तो आपको मौका देते हैं आपको लेकिन बैठे-बैठे वोट टिप्पणी करते हो
सर. I apologize, sir. Sir, I first I'd like to congratulate a young and dynamic minister. We wish you very best for the part of DMK party. We really welcome you. Your father was a good friend of DMK. Sir, I have the habit of booking out my ticket for Delhi online through Vistara Airlines, which belongs to Tata's. And the software is handled by Tata's TCS. So this is seen, every time I see, when I book a ticket, it's around 33,000 rupees, sir, one-way ticket from Chennai to Delhi. When I go to make the payment, an error message comes. The moment the error message comes, the price goes to 93,000 rupees or 78,000 rupees.
What?
Yes, sir. Yeah, yeah. This has been happening because probably Tata TCS is using its supremacy in the software. And because we have everyone's got a miles account, so we are logged in. So this is happening very frequently, even from Delhi to Chennai or Chennai. So this doesn't come under the DGCA rules, because DGCA is only in charge when the airline cancels a flight or reschedules a flight. But this is happening in software, right? Sir, there's a conspiracy happening. And would like you to do an inquiry, thorough inquiry, because Tata now is the monopoly in the business segment. So money is paid by the government of India. The ticket fare.
Mane Mantri ji, Mane Sadash ne bahut gambhir vishay uthaya hai. Aur ye bahut gambhir hai, iski jaanch honi chahiye. Ye kai Mane Sadashyon ne shikayat ki, kyunki iska paisa parliament se jata hai. Isliye main chinta hai.
Definitely, sir. We'll get the matter investigated. And also, our senior member has mentioned, DGCA looks after the rights of the passengers and it dwells into that. And also there is DGCA traffic monitoring, tariff monitoring unit also, which looks after this specific issue that you have said. So we are going to investigate that. We are going to ensure that this kind of incidents doesn't happen in the future, sir. Thank you.
Question number 4.